Do you know that it has actually rained during National Day before? And the story of the authorities using crowd seeding to stop rain might be as fake as you saying that your friend's kids are cute when you think that they are devils. Watch on, and then you'll know whether you will rain this NDP or not. So, do a Google search online and you'll see this. Shockingly, Google didn't just show the results. They are so confident that they answered the question on the search result page, saying it never rains on Singapore's National Day. Here's the thing, Google is wrong. Then what the research I did for my previous videos? You see, first of all, let's address the rumors that we have all been hearing. It's rumored that the authorities do some crowd seeding to ensure that every 9 August there won't be any rain. Now, this sounds like a good feel-good story that we can go, Singapore is using planes to ensure that it never rains during National Day Parade, and that's shockingly amazing, bossy! That's 1 minute, see you tomorrow! But no way. You see, let's look at the science first. There is indeed a technology called crowd seeding, whereby a plane drops some things on a huge crowd that makes the crowd rain. This technology is often used in extreme situations, like an area is having a wildfire and so, when there's a big crowd above it, they induce rain there before the crowd is carried away by the wind. The other uses are to make it rain or snow instead of huge, like tiny things dropping on you one. So basically, this technology is used to create rain, not to prevent rain. I know that sometimes there are theories that this could be used to prevent rain also by making the crowds around an area rain. But that is often disputed. Cause for the technology to crowd seed is legit, to use it to stop rain is still very, very debatable. When Beijing wanted that so that it doesn't rain during the Beijing Olympics in 2008, a leading expert on weather modification said, we cannot make crowds or chase crowds away. While it seems like it works, there were debates on whether the crowd seeding around the area contributes to it or not. But in Singapore, it's even trickier, cause how the heck can we seed crowds around us since we are so small? Which now leads to the burning question. Has it rained during NDP before? Yes. In fact, it rained on the very first NDP in 1966. Back then, NDP was decentralized and occurred during the day, so it means it occurred in a few places. The NDP started at 9 AM, and at 10:40 AM, when people were marching not just at the Padang but various places as well, it started to rain. People still watch under the rain, cause last time, people watch events with their eyes, not with their phones. And in 1968, on 9 August, it rained again. So yes, there's always a risk of rain on every 9 August, and based on history so far, the events still continue. But of course, given how much safety is being imposed nowadays, and how kids nowadays will melt when they touch rainwater, I bet that now it's a different story altogether. But why does it often not rain during 9 August? The reason is simple. August is usually one of the drier months in Singapore, so the chances of rain during 9 August are much lower. In fact, I think you can already feel the heat nowadays. So basically, if you think about it, raining on 9 August is like about 40, chances of it happening is very low, but it still happen, but you still never strike.